Well, Americans facing retirement are now the fastest growing group of people filing for bankruptcy. A new study by the Consumer Bankruptcy Project reveals the rate of people older than 65 who filed for bankruptcy has tripled since 1991. Those seniors now represent more than 12% of all bankruptcy filers. The number has skyrocketed nearly 500% in 25 years. CBS News business analyst Jill Schlesinger joins us at the table with more on this rather revealing and startling survey. Jill, The economy's doing so well now. Why are more seniors retiring?
I think these are longer.
Or filing for bankruptcy, I mean.
Yeah, right? The problem is that these are longer term trends, and certainly the Great Recession accelerated it. But when you think about it, a lot of these people thought, hey, I'm going to be able to retire when I'm 62, and they really may not have been able to, or they had to wait a little bit longer for Social Security. We also know in the early 80s that 401k plans, which are voluntary, basically started to replace guaranteed corporate pensions. And that was a huge shift for so many Americans. We also know that we're shouldering a larger share of healthcare costs, out of pocket, deductibles rising. And you put all of this against a backdrop where median household income, while it's improved recently, the economy has done really well, over the last 20, 30 years, incomes are essentially stagnant. So this has become a huge problem for those folks coming into retirement. I should also mention, they're coming into retirement with a ton of debt, Credit card debt, mortgage debt. Fastest growing segment of student loan borrowers are over 55. It's not for them, it's for their kids and their grandkids.
Right. So you touched on medical costs being a problem. Why?
Well, what's happened is we now know that the median 65-year-old has about $60,000 in the bank. That's huge. That's a big number
for
a that's their savings. Mm-hmm. But the bottom 25% have just about $3,300. $3,300, you could have a simple illness and that gets wiped out. And these medical bills don't get erased. A lot of the people who responded to this survey said it was the medical or health situations that exacerbated something terrible, forced them into a bankruptcy.
So, Joe, what should people who are planning for retirement do to avoid bankruptcy?
I know, I feel terrible because a lot of the people who are there already, there is not much to do. But I should say that if you're in your 40s and your 50s, obviously saving more money is important, but we really want to encourage people to not claim Social Security at age 62. You can claim as early as 62, but your benefits are permanently reduced by up to 25%. That can impact a non-working spouse who's claiming on your record. We would love you to actually retire with a minimal debt. And also, the longer you work, even if it's just a few months, even in just a year, can make an incremental difference for your retirement. So don't claim at 62, work longer, clear out that debt, say no to your kids, because we know that too many people are actually absorbing the debt of their children for themselves.
That may be the hardest part.
Work as long as you can. Mm-hmm. All right. Thank you, Jill.